Hello everybody, and welcome back to my real let's play of Doom 3, Resurrection of Evil. From where we last left off, we've successfully reached Sector 1 of the Phobos Labs, where we encountered the Hell Knight and the Commando Zombies. Now we're going into Sector 2 of the Phobos Labs, where we get a rendezvous with Dr Elizabeth McNeil. Now, as usual, we're going to have to wait for this to load. Oh, just bar me while I get this sorted out. Oh, and as you can still see, my health is at 42% already, and no armor. It means I'm really more vulnerable to any penetrating attacks. Ah! Look at this, there's always some medkits around here. And still, I suppose you've all heard about the recent death of Don Rickles, the comedian and actor. We all know it's Mr. Potato Head, the voice of Mr. Potato Head in the Toy Story movies. If you don't know what he sounds like, it's like this. But hey, Ham! Look! I'm Picasso! You uncultured swine! What are you looking at, you hockey puck? Come on, do you have to admit I sound a bit like Don Rickles when I do Mr. Potato Head? And I'm not sure Pixar would cast me as Potato Head in Toy Story 4, if they can be doing. In that meeting, then he goes like this. Of course Woody ain't worried. He's been Andy's favourite since kindergarten. I mean, I don't know if Mr. Potato Head would sound weird with a Yorkshire accent. That's part of me, I've still got this cough. And still, I won't forget the scene where Woody accidentally knocked Buzz out of the window. Well, it's a good thing the Volk is not paying any attention to me. Okay. Yeah, I noticed there's some flashing lights right here. And again, if you have epilepsy, I would advise avoid watching this. And back to my Mr. Potato Head impression. I know in that scene where, you know, after Woody knocked Buzz out the window, he went like this. You just couldn't handle Buzz cutting out your playtime, could you, Woody? Didn't want to face the fact that Buzz just might be Andy's new favourite toy. So you got rid of him. Well, what if Andy starts playing with me more, Woody, huh? You gonna knock me out of a window too? Still, you know, Don Rickles recently died of like kidney failure. Same as like Pat Morita and Ernest Borgnine. Well, you didn't want to face the fact that Don Rickles was gonna reprise his role as Potato Head in Toy Story 4. So that kidney failure got rid of him. Well, what if I got the same illness as him, huh? Am I gonna suffer the same fate too? I mean, come on, they're like Alan Rickman again with his pancreatic cancer. I mean, what if I keep refusing his death? I keep refusing to accept his death, huh? Am I gonna suffer the same illness as him too? And back to the scene where, and also the scene I remember in that Toy Story 1 where Woody was trying to get help from. And his friends across Andy's house since Christmas lights, and Potato Head went like this. Hey, I got a better idea. How about we don't? And he's like, did you all take stupid pills this morning? Have you forgotten what he did to Buzz? And now you want to let him back over here? And then still he went like this, like a bit later on. He's like, hang on just a minute. What are you trying to pull? Oh god. You gotta love Mr. Potato Head's voice. You know, after Woody revealed Buzz's broken arm. And he was like, murderer! You're murdering dog! Save it for the jury. I hope Sid pulls your voice box out, you creep. But it's like, come on, let's get out of here. And that was the part where Ham was kind of like, go back to your lives, citizens. Show's over. Oh, God. I know he got married to Mrs. Potato Head in Toy Story 2. I don't know how he goes again. Oh, yeah, he went like this. One scene after they found Woody. Like, prepare to meet Mr. Angry Eyes! And in Toy Story 3, he went like this. You're not a toy! You're an accessory! You're a purse with legs! You would not believe what I've been through tonight! Like, Hey, I told you kids, stay out of my butt! In the meantime, let's pick up this PDA. Have a quick read for it. Oh, come on, you! So, yep, that was a revenant. Oi, you! This is not a good time for fighting! I have to read that PDA! Unless you want another shot in the skull again! But ballrooms are for meetings, not fights! Oh, don't tell me. It's enough from them vulgars. Oh, I can't grab his missiles properly. There we go, that takes care of him. Well, there's no more. I mean, just my thought this year was going to turn out pretty well, apart from last year with the depths of famous celebrities like David Bowie, Alan Rickman, Joel Alaskin, Victoria Wood, Jack Riley, and many others, like Carrie Fisher. I mean, it doesn't matter if they're gone. I mean, people die every day. I mean, I know they're still with us. With the actors from last year, who died last year. I mean, they're still with us, even here. Like I already mentioned, Alan Rickman, Victoria Wood, Carrie Fisher, everyone from last year. They didn't die in vain. Not you again! That was a bruiser, in case you're wondering. And now I've got the artifact handy. This will be coming handy for facing the likes of him. I mean, in the last mission, it was tricky without using it. There we go, that takes care of him. Now, where do we go to next? Oh yeah, let's go through here. Obviously, the sentry bot guarding Dr. McNeil's office. Let's see what she has to say.
God, it's good to see you. There's so much I need to explain, but we don't have much time. The artifact is a gateway from hell, much like the one that Petruger opened with the teleporters in the Delta Labs. With the artifact, though, as long as it resides in our dimension, there's always the danger of it being awakened, and then another invasion. The ancients knew it, and now we know it. It must be returned to the source of its evil in order to be destroyed. They couldn't do it, so they locked it away and fought to their death. You can use the Delta Teleporter to return the artifact to hell for good. I know this sounds crazy, but it's the only way. The important thing right now is getting the Phobos Teleporter online. There are 4 core systems that must be shut down before I can reroute the power to the Teleporter. Take this. You'll need it to get to the pumping station. Now go.
Yeah, you might notice there's a glitch with the tablets and power sources. Another sentry bot right here. Dear me. I've got to sort this cop out. No, yeah, I forgot to mention about her voice. And, you know, Dr. McNeil's voice by, like, Jennifer Hale, I think. What I know is Princess Morbucks in the Powerpuff Girls, and also Seducer, in that episode where she made an appearance as I'm a Good Lady. Well, she started off as a kind-hearted woman, but then she reveals her true colours to the girls. I mean, you should have seen her way after they tidied up the room. To the living room. She made a mess of everything again! And also, I know Seducer's like a parody of Medusa. Except Seducer doesn't have the ability to turn people into stone by staring at them. Except she uses her hair to attack. That was quite good for her hair. Until Miss Bellum cut it off in one episode. You may remember that. And also, in Codename Kids Next Door, she did the voice of number 86. You know her? Oh yeah, we know her by her stroppy ways. And also, not to mention she's the head of decommissioning. I mean, I can't do her impressions. I can't do her voice, really. She's basically a female character. Okay, we can't go through here. And this means we have to use the airlock again. Ah, me. And then once again, prepare to get your spacesuits ready. We need the machine gun out for this endeavor, just in case. Yeah, there's forgotten ones outside this time. And I still don't know how they're able to breathe outside this harsh environment. And again, we still need these oxygen tanks in order to survive out of Mars, in this Mars surface. And like I already mentioned, yeah, I can't go on Mars, because I won't be able to breathe without any oxygen. Which is, should use the rocket launcher on this remnant. He's going to be a pain in the bum again, just like in the original Doom 3. Hey, where's the nearby tank? Ah, there it is. Oh. Oh, don't tell me, I even got enough. I've got all day. Ah. Oh. Oh. I nearly suffocated. Oh, finally. Do I need to get some air? Hello.
Disengaged.
Oh, I better take care of this revenant first. But... Oh. Oh yeah, I forgot about this guy here. Seth Killian, oh yeah! Not him! Let's get our health up first before listening to his PDA. Let's see here. Nope. And I always find it wrong to snoop into people's emails. Oh, there we go, help me.
This is maintenance technician Seth Killian. I'm looking for anyone that's survived, but... What the... I don't know what these things are after, but... They're killing everything. I've got to get out of here. I'm going to try and take the maintenance tunnels to Mars City to get an emergency evac. If you find this... And it probably...
Okay, well, you know, this time around we're not hearing any demon noises. But luckily, like the Resurrection of Evil, all your files that I might find on YouTube. Let's see if I can find them. Ah, here we go. Let's see, here we go. Okay, listen to this, everybody. This is Seth Killian's... The original audio log was Seth Killian from the original Doom 3 Resurrection of Evil. The volume turned up so you'll be able to hear it.
This is maintenance technician Seth Killian. I'm looking for anyone that's survived, but... What the... I don't know what these things are after, but... They're killing everything. I gotta get out of here. I'm gonna try and take the maintenance tunnels to Mars City to get an emergency evac. If you find this, then it's...
Well, that was an unexpected turn of events, wasn't it? A demon killing somebody when they're doing the audio log? We don't know what that could be. Might be one of the Hell Knights or one of the Hunters. Might have killed him. It might be one of the Hell Knights, I don't know. It sounded like a Hell Knight to me. Oh, well, here again, eh? Ah! Oh! The Detective Forgotten One's log to come out of nowhere like that! Why do I need the pistol? I don't use it more often. Oh great, this is what we need again. A cacodemon. Oh, that's really wasting my time. You're wasting my oxygen and my time. I need to get in there quickly. Oh, just in time. And I didn't need the artifact this time. Oh, come on, you. Die. I haven't got time to deal with the likes of you. Uh-oh. Oh, he knew I was going to come down here. They just keep on coming! Oh no. Might need the artifact here to speed things up. Here you go, ah! And there's a Super Turbo Turkey Puncher 3 game. I haven't got time to play! Ah! Oh. Oh great, I can't go into the restrooms. Nice try to kill these zombies! You have to think twice to outsmart me. Oh, nearly got him. That's not gonna help. Now I've charged up the artifact again. I need to find a way to get it back into hell. Before something even worse happens.
Warning. Automated turret guns online.
Oh, great. I'm trying a way to shut that off. And here we go with that again. Let's have a look. PDA again. There we go. Bridge code. 281. That's what we need. See, 281.
Automated turret guns offline. Service bridge now operational.
Now what? Nice. I think I got mine in the nuts. And his nuts too. Ah, there's a plasma gun. Just in case if anybody has missed it. Get that turret gun there just in case if anybody tries to intrude. Now what? Oh yeah, we can continue for everyone to shut down one of the reactors. Oh great. Oh yeah, I forgot about the security code. I mean, I almost forgot about that. Sure, it'll be quicker if I sprint.
Granted.
Oh, thank goodness for that. Whoa! Where'd you come from? A chain gun should speed things up a bit. Oh, get away from the walls, you. They're not Spider-Man, you know, or the imps. Well, technically they do the same thing as the imps do in this game. It take care of these skeleton demons. Oh, great. That's not a good time for me at this moment. Oh, thank goodness there's some armor right here. Thought it was a definite weapon. Uh-oh. I hear something strange. Oh yeah, it's a good thing the autosave kicked in. It's just in case we die here, because there's a boss coming up here. But believe me. I mean, this is going to be the trickiest boss we'll ever face in Resurrection of Evil. As soon as we go in here, we'll face a bulkier Hell Hunter. You'll see why. That's him here! That's the Invulnerability Hunter! See what he's doing right here? Feeding energy from those cores. Makes him... failure. Now! Now, it's just like the Hell Knights, we have to avoid his fire blast attacks. His fireball attacks. Look at him, he's bulkier than the Berserk Hunter and the Helltime Hunter. Ow! You still have to watch out for his fireball attacks. Oh, I can't go on the ground this time. Like in the PC and the Xbox version. Ow! Believe you. Oh, great. What are you doing? Oh, I can just use the chain gun on him. Now's a good time to use the artifact. I have to act quickly right here when you're in berserk mode. Oh. When you're fighting the Invulnerability Hunter right here, you have to act quickly. Correct. These Hell Hunters must have come here for the artifact. Use every ounce of ammo I've got on him. Oh, you have to watch out when he does that. You're pouncing the floor with his energy waves. He'll damage you when you're on that. Especially if you're underneath him this ground on the PC and the Xbox version of the original Resurrection of Evil. Now, to use the artifact again. Huh, I can't cause it one hit when I'm in Berserk mode and Helltime mode.
Three failure.
Yeah, great, that's just what we've been waiting for to hear. No way I could go up against a bulky titan like him! Whoa, back off when he does that! Now is a good time to use it again! Huh. Ouch! Now he's more vulnerable to my attacks now. The artifact really should speed things up a tad. Okay, I've only got one shot at this. Ah, see what I mean? You have to be careful when he does that. He's more larger than a Hell Knight. These Hell Hunters must have been sent here by Betruger to kill me, because I've got the artifact right here. Now to make up this battle. Oh yeah. Yes! Got him! He's the final one down! Yes! Finally done it!
Considering power down. Right.
Now I've got the powers of all the...
Now take the sky train to the reactor complex. You can access the last two systems from there.
Now I've got the powers of all the Hell Hunters. See here. And again, it's like what we just saw said in Ben 10 Ultimate Alien. You know, after Aggro absorbed the five aliens, he's like, "You killed them!" And Aggro was like, "I absorbed them. All their powers mine." I wasted my pistol on one of the forgotten ones outside. Now we can head back to the Sky Tram. Alright, before we do that, more things to worry about. Oh. Anyway.
Access granted.
Oh, now what? Oh, not you again! It's one of the bruisers! Where's he going now? Oh yeah, but he's going through the door, isn't he? Going through where I am. You may remember him in my last play, the last mission. I have a feeling he's going to come through here. Oh. Well, now I've got the artifact handy. Time to go up against him. Oh! Got him in the back! Now that, my friends, is called stabbing your friends in the back. Don't tell me there's another one outside. Shame I can't use my fist against him. See, I've got the powers now from these Hell Hunters I've killed. Oh, thank goodness there's not another bruiser. In the meantime, let's have a look. David Edens, that's what it's called. We haven't got time to do all this. Now, where did the other one go? Ah. Oh dear, now I've got another one of these bruisers. I'm not going to try to do it like I did in the last mission. You know, like running away from him and shooting him whenever he comes near me. Oh, this cough isn't really helping me. In this relaxed play. Oh, I think that's that. Oh, what a tough battle this was. Killing all the demons and finally the Invulnerability Hunter. So anyway, I will have to cut off here, but I will see you next time as we go through the Phobos section to shut down the life support systems. And so until then, bye!